Today we'll be vaccinating against koi herpes virus. In every country which produces carp and koi today, the virus is present. KHV, as it's known, is a deadly disease caused by a virus known as koi herpes virus or cyprinid herpes virus type 3, which afflicts ornamental koi and edible carp populations. Infected ponds experience an 80 to 100% mortality rates, and the disease is seasonal in its nature. It would appear in water temperatures between 18 to 28 degrees Celsius. The only way to prevent an outbreak of KHV is through vaccination. We have generated a vaccine named KV3, basically mimicking wild-type infection, generating a very strong, durable immune response against the wild-type infection, but not causing the disease caused by the wild-type virus. There are several ways that we vaccinate fish these days, through injection and through immersion vaccines or through feed. The advantages of using the KV3 vaccine is that it's efficient through an immersion vaccine, which is much simpler and cost-effective than an injectable one. The vaccination process with KV3 is very simple. Everything you need to vaccinate is within the farm setting and is integrated with the growth of the fish. A prerequisite for vaccination is to have healthy fish. In other words, if you fear your fish have a presence of parasites or bacteria, you should treat that first prior to vaccination. So first thing to do is to net the fish from the pond. Fish are corralled from within the mud pond where the koi are grown traditionally and are transported through buckets into a transportation tank, which are used in every farm to move fish from one place to the other. Once in the transportation tank, we calculate the amount of biomass we have of fish within the tank. Each 100 milliliter bottle would vaccinate 200 kilograms of koi and 300 kilograms of carp. We monitor the oxygen level and add oxygen as needed to reduce stress within the fish. We then replace the water within the tank with clean water to reduce the amount of organic matter and dirt brought in from the pond to get the best out of the vaccine. Once we replace the water within the transportation tank, we then move on to reduce the water level within the tank. The water ratio should be 200 kilograms of koi for each cubic meter of water and 300 kilograms of carp for every cubic meter of water. Once we adjust the water level and the temperature within the transportation tank, we then move on to the vaccination process. Vaccine bottles are thawed and then poured directly into the transportation tank according to the biomass of fish that we have within the tank. The dosage required is every 100 milliliter bottle is enough to vaccinate 200 kilograms of koi or 300 kilograms of carp within 1 cubic meter of water. Following the addition of the vaccine to the transportation tank, we need to maintain the fish there for 45 minutes to 1 hour, monitoring throughout the whole period the oxygen level and the water temperature to allow proper vaccination. For proper vaccination to take place, we need to maintain the fish in a controlled environment after the immersion period, meaning fish are moved into controlled KHV-free ponds, where water temperature should be maintained for at least 5 days at 22 to 26 degrees Celsius. Following that period, we need to maintain the fish ultimately for 3 weeks in a KHV-free area to allow the fish to be immunized properly. The KV3 vaccine is easily administered to fish, is highly effective in the prevention of disease caused by koi herpes virus. After 3 weeks, fish are properly vaccinated and can continue their grow-out phase as usual. KV3 is currently the only available licensed vaccine in the world which prevents outbreaks of KHV.